The initial set of four Arleigh Burke-class destroyers, slated for significant upgrades, has been officially named by the U.S. Navy. USS James E. Williams, DDG-95, USS Chung Hoon, DDG-93, USS Halsey, DDG-97, and USS Pinckney, DDG-91, are slated to undergo upgrades to the DDG-51 Mod 2.0 or DDG-2.0 standard. The designation DDG-51 corresponds to the hull number of the USS Arleigh Burke, the lead ship in the class. U.S. Navy Captain Tim Moore, who's in charge of what is currently known as the Destroyer Modernization 2.0 program, provided key insights regarding the upgrade effort at the Surface Navy Association's main annual symposium. This is part of the Navy's broader modernization plans for its destroyer fleets, which also includes the plan to develop and acquire an entirely new design currently known as DDG-X. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how three key additions in the Mod 2.0 package will make Arleigh Burke destroyers even more deadly. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The warships will receive an upgraded Aegis combat system. While the exact variant of the new Aegis combat system baseline to be incorporated has not been disclosed, this could be Baseline 10. Aegis weapon system Baseline 10 software is based on a new architecture. Lockheed Martin states that this will increase the speed at which new upgrades can be made to the system. Lockheed aims to leverage this innovative architecture to significantly reduce the usual timeline for delivering a new capability to the fleet. It will work with the Common Source Library, or CSL, that will combine all Surface Navy capabilities into a single software repository. Baseline 10 is anticipated to enable the team to incorporate new capabilities into the library within 3 to 4 weeks. Rather than the extended period of 3 to 4 months in some instances. The company reports that it's been increasingly automating tests to expedite the verification of software updates, referring to Baseline 10 as the most comprehensive evolution of an Aegis baseline to date. SEWIP Block 3, being developed by Northrop Grumman and the U.S. Navy Program Executive Office Integrated Warfare System, PEOIWS, is the third in a series of incremental upgrades that adds an electronic attack, or EA, capability to the ANSLQ-32 Electronic Warfare, EW, system to defend ships against anti-ship missiles. The SEWIP Block 3 suite from Northrop Grumman has a significant advancement in capabilities compared to prior iterations of the ANSLQ-32 system. The updated version incorporates Active Electronically Scanned Array, or AESA, technology, which can emit potent and precisely focused bursts of radio frequency, or RF, energy. This capability enables the initiation of electronic attacks on multiple targets along various vectors simultaneously. Additionally, the variant possesses advanced passive capabilities for detecting, geolocating, and categorizing threats. In addition to its fundamental capabilities, it has the versatility to serve as a communications node and even function as a radar system. Furthermore, its design allows for continuous upgrades over the span of decades. Northrop Grumman states that the SEWIP Block 3 system is inherently multifunction, creating an expanded mission set to defeat emergent threats and support the U.S. Navy's Distributed Maritime Operations, or DMO, CONOPS. To keep pace with the rapid advances in technology, SEWIP Block 3 has an open, software-designed architecture which can today enable communication enhancements and information operations, as well as support future upgrades such as cognitive EW and AI/machine learning. Since it'll be able to disrupt the RF guidance, the system will be used as a non-kinetic weapon against incoming threats such as missiles and drones. The important part is that unlike kinetic operations like the evolved Sea Sparrow missile present on the Burkes, this system can be used repeatedly without having the fear of running out. So, SEWIP Block 3 will ensure a revolutionary leap in defensive as well as offensive electronic warfare capability for the U.S. Navy's surface fleet. Viewers may note USS Pinckney has already gotten its new electronic warfare system. The inclusion of the system has significantly transformed the appearance of the ship, introducing two large, fully enclosed extensions on either side of the primary superstructure. Raytheon's AnSpy-6 V radar is a scaled-down derivative of the AnSpy-6V1 Air and Missile Defense Radar (AMDR) that's a key component of the Flight 3 Arleigh Burke design. It's an active, electronically scanned array 3D radar developed for the United States Navy. All AnSpy-6 radars feature active, electronically scanned arrays and are made up of groups of cube-shaped radar modular assemblies, RMAs. The V1 version has 4 fixed arrays each with 37 RMAs. The V4 has 4 fixed arrays as well, but with 24 RMAs apiece. AnSpy 6V4 is designed to provide integrated air and missile defense for Flight 3 Arleigh Burke-class destroyers. The system consists of 2 primary radars and a radar suite controller (RSC) to coordinate the sensors. An S-band radar is to provide volume search, tracking, ballistic missile defense discrimination, and missile communications, while the X-band radar is to provide horizontal search, precision tracking, missile communication, and terminal illumination of targets. The transmit-receive modules use new gallium nitride (GaN) semiconductor technology, allowing for a higher power density than the previous gallium arsenide radar modules. AnSpy 6V4 will be able to track more targets at greater ranges with greater precision and fidelity than the AnSpy 1 passive electronically scanned array radars currently found on older Arleigh Burke-class warships. The addition of AnSpy 6V4, along with SEWIP Block 3, will result in higher cooling requirements, so a new cooling module will be installed in these ships.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.